فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Get through to a rock, it can change its color. It can also what? It can also dense the rock with consistency. Then how can I not get through to grammar? صح? And study. So brothers, I promise you, if you give your whole life to this, you'll get to the bottom of it. Well, not the bottom of it, but you'll get far, inshallah. That's what I mean. Every single day I learn something new. Every day. So if I stopped 5 years ago, then I wouldn't have learned what I've learned today. And that's how it is. I realize every day. Yesterday, wallahi, I learned things that I didn't know the day before that. And today I'm going to learn some things, inshallah ta'ala, that I didn't know yesterday. And that's how a person's life is going to be. Just consistency. Carrying on. Not giving up. Going on. And I tell you, brothers, it is hard to be consistent. Wallahi, it's the hardest thing. But it's the underlining factor which I read from the biography of the ulama. If you ask me one thing in which I can say Ahmad ibn Hanbal and Shafi'i and Abu Dawood and Bukhari and all of them, what did they have in common? One underlining thing I believe they all had in common was consistency. They were consistent, wallahi. 40 years, Ahmad ibn Hanbal did not marry until he became a scholar. Yeah? Sheikh Al-Albani, first book he wrote, Ittikhad al-Sajid, he was 23. Albani died at what age? 84. How many years is that? 63 years of his life he was serving hadith. Are you with me, brothers? Sometimes he will say, وَقَدْ كَتَبْتُ فِي هَذِهِ I wrote about this mas'ala قَبْلَ 30 سَنَةً 30 years ago. Are you with me, brothers? That is patience. We learn for 5 years, wallahi, we think Bukhari is our second name. So that's the reality. So let's be consistent, inshallah ta'ala. If you hear about another dawra by any person, it doesn't have to be me, but somebody else, come, study. You hear it in your local masjid, that there's a halaqah going on, tahfidh of the Qur'an. Brothers, don't give up, man. Go, memorize the Qur'an in the halaqah. If you know there's a brother in your local area, he knows hadith, he knows this, sit and learn from him. Huh? Sit and what? Learn. It's important. Allahumma allimna ma yanfa'una. Oh Allah, teach us what we need and what's going to benefit us. And don't make what you taught us a proof and a hujjah against us. Na'am.
وتجد صيغة الأمن والمراد به الإباحة أو التحديد أو التسوية أو التكوين.
The author now, rahimahullah, he talks about a mas'ala connected to Amr, which is sometimes the word if'al is used in the Sharia, but it's not meant by Amr. Allah says it comes in the form of if'al. If'al was what? Siyagh al-sariha, right? It was a direct form of being commanded to do something, right? But it doesn't necessarily mean that it's wajib. It just means that it's mubah. Or it can even be a tahdeed. Tahdeed means you're being actually warned. It's actually you're being threatened. Like qawluhu ta'ala, the statement of Allah. قُلْ تَمَتَّعْ بِكُفْرِكَ قَلِيلًا تَمَتَّعْ بِكُفْرِكَ Enjoy your kufr. Isn't tamatta', isn't that a command? It's a command. Is it like in commanding them to enjoy kufr? What is it? The hadid. Is that when your parents say to you, huh? Hey, arad, bahr, sahika, hey, arad. Go with your friends, hey, go. What is that? It's a bab, nah, I wasn't thinking about it. I'm going to stay, of course. I'm going to take care of you. That's what you have to say straight away. It's a command, but it's tahdeed. So he's trying to tell you that the word if'al, sometimes it's Amr, which is the Asl, that's the default position. But sometimes it can be Mubah. It can be actually Mubah. It's used, but it doesn't mean Wajib. And we took example for that. It can also be a Tahdeed. It can also be Taswiya, which is that it's basically saying that two things are the same. Allah says, Fasbiru, aw la tasbiru. Be patient, or don't be patient. It's equal. Does that make sense? So here Allah, when He says, Fasbiru, be patient. Aw la tasbiru, or don't be patient. It's the same. The issue of takween is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is requesting for something to be. It's not that you're being commanded here. It's not that you're being prohibited from something. It's just Allah is commanding something to become about. And it's what the scholars will call ijad. And it's when Allah said, kunu qiradatan khasi'in. Be monkeys that are destroyed. Kunu, be. Kunu is a fi'l amr. But are you being commanded to do something? No, Allah is saying for something to be. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's what the author now is talking about. It's a chapter that falls under, this point falls under the Amr that we spoke about previously. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we finished speaking about Amr and we finished speaking about Nahi. The author now is going to go into an Am and Khas. General ruling and specific ruling. Hey?
من قولي عممت زيدا وعمرا بالعطاء وعممت جميع الناس بالعطاء وثره أربعة الاسم الواحد المعرف بالله والوصف الجمع المعرف بالله والأسماء المبهمة كمن وفي من يعقل وما في ما لا يعقل وأي في الجميع وأين في المكان ومتى في الزمان وما في الاستفهام والجزاء وغيره ولا في النكرات والعموم من صفات النطق ولا يجوز دعوى العموم في غيره من الفعل ويجري مجراه
صح؟ The author, rahimahullah, now goes into a unit from the unit of Usul al-Fiqh, which is known as Am, general. The textual evidences which are general. What is general? The author defines it. He tells us the reality of what it means, Am. He says, هُوَ مَا عَمَّ شَيْئَيْنِ فَصَاعِدًا Until he said, rahimahullah, مِنْ قَوْلِهِ عَمَمْتُ زَيْدًا وَعَمْرًا بِالْعَطَاءِ وَعَمَمْتُ جَمِيعَ النَّاسِ بِالْعَطَاءِ All of that is his definition of what it means, Am. And that definition of his is a had lughawi. It's more of a lexical, linguistic definition of the word. And it's not really a usuli definition of what it means, am, general. So he's kind of defining it, what it means in the language. The definition that it should be in usul al-fiqh is al-qawlu al-mawdu', it is the word that is placed, al-qawlu al-mawdu'. It is the word that is placed لِاسْتِغْرَاقِ جَمِيعِ أَفْرَاد بِلَا حَصْرٍ It is speech that is placed, it is put in place to encompass all of these sub-branches under it without any exclusivity. It's not exclusive to any of those branches, it encompasses it all. So if you look at my definition, it really encompasses two main points. The first one is it has to be speech. According to the Usuliyin, Am is not actions. We're going to see that later, inshaAllah ta'ala. You can't take generalization from actions. When it comes to Am, it's taken what? فَمَوْرِدُ الْعُمُومِ الْأَقْوَالِ The source in which generalization initiates from is speech. And we'll see that, inshaAllah ta'ala, there's a whole chapter called Af'al, actions. We'll see in there more pertaining to the issue of generalization, whether it can take actions. The second point regarding the definition I put forward is that this generalization has to be placed by the Arabic language. According to the Arabs, when you look at their speech, it has to be something that they consider to be general. Then the author, rahimahullah, he says, وَأَلْفَاظُهُ أَرْبَعَةٌ Now the author is going to give us the wordings in which the Arabs have placed for generalization. When the Arabs use a word and they mean it general, the author mentions to us, inshallah, four types of words that if it's used, it shows generalization. Before we go into those four, are these the only four that the Arabs use to show generalization? Is it only these four? Or is it more? It's more. But the reason why he used it is لِشْتِهَارِهَا. It's very famous. These are the four most common wordings which the Arabs use to show generalization. The first one is اسم الواحد المعرف باللامي. The first one is the singular word, the alif and lam enters it. The second one is اسم الجمع المعرف باللام. The second one is a plural noun, the alif and lam enters it. No, I'm coming to that. The author is taking the madhab of those who believe that when you look at the alif alam, that the mu'arraf in English means definite, and a nakira in English is indefinite. A definite word in the Arabic language, according to the scholars, is two madhabs. There's a madhab that sees that what makes the word mu'arraf is the lam, and the alif is alif al-wasl. That's one madhab. That's the madhab that the author takes here right now. He believes that when he said al-ism al-wahid al-mu'arraf bil-lam, that it's the word becomes mu'arraf, which is definite, through the lam, and the alif has nothing to do with it. That's the opinion that he's inclined to. There's another view of ulama who believe that the word becomes definite through the alif and lam together. So that's why he said al-mu'arrafi bil-lam. And as you all know, there's also another third view which the author didn't mention, is that there are some scholars who actually believe that am is the same as al. There's a lugha min lughati al-arab who used the alif al-lam and am. Am is also a form of what? Mu'arraf. Huh? And we all know that the alif al-lam are not all mu'arraf. Sometimes it can be a sila. رَأَيْتُ الْوَلِيدَ ابْنَ الْيَزِيدَ مُبَارَكٌ بِأَعْبَاءِ الْخِلَافَةِ كَاهِلٌ, as the poet said. رَأَيْتُ, I saw, الْوَلِيد. Walid is already mu'arraf, he's a name. Everyone knows Walid. But there's an alif al-lam in it. That alif al-lam is called what? Zaida. It doesn't make the word a mu'arraf. It doesn't make the word definite, necessarily. Are you with me, brothers? The word am is also a mu'arraf, according to a madhab min lughat min lughat al-arab. Sibawayh rahimah, Suyuti rahimahullah, he wrote a risala on this. A juz saghir, I don't remember the name right now, it doesn't come to my mind, of this issue. What is the alif al-lam that enters a singular noun or a plural noun that gives generalization to the wording? What's that called in Arabic? It's called al-istighraqiyyah. What's that called? Al-istighraqiyyah. Istighraqiyyah means that it makes the what? So if singular noun, alif al-lam that enters it, to show it generalization, you say that this alif al-lam is called what? Istighraqiyyah. Or if you have the madhab that believes that it's the lam alone, then you say the lam is istighraqiyyah. Sometimes the alif al-lam can be ahadiyyah. Ahadiyyah means me and you are talking and I say, jaa al-waladu, the boy came. I'm talking about the boy that you and I were talking to the other day, he came. Al-walad, this here, is not istighraqi. It doesn't mean all of the boys came. No. It means the one you and I were both talking about the other day. It's Does it make sense? Are you there, brothers? It is mu'arraf here, but it's ahdiya, it's not istighraqiyya. Does that make sense, brothers? Example for this is wal asr. Innal insana. Al insan here is what? Is it some people are going to be destroyed and in a state of loss, or it means all of the people? Brothers? All of people, where's the evidence for that? Istighraqiyya, sah? This alif and lam in here is what? Insan here, is it plural or is it singular? It's a singular. So your qa'idah is what? Al-ismul wahid al-mu'arrafi bil-lam. It shows generalization. The author mentioned a third. So we mentioned already two, right? What's the third one? The third one is al-asma al-mubhama. Asma al-mubhama is also the third thing, but the third wording in which the Arabs use that show generalization. Al-asma al-mubhama. Asma al-mubhama are like man, ma. Are you with me, brothers? In the Arabic language, the asma are categorized into three. Asma which are mudmar, asma which are mudhar, and asma which are mubham. And when you come to Bab al-I'rab, when you come to the grammatical analysis of a word, in the Arabic language, the only one that's done I'rab with is what? Asma which are mudhar. We don't do I'rab of dhamair, pronouns. Are you with me, brothers? Nor do we do I'rab of what? Nor do we do I'rab of asma which are mubhama. The only asma that we do i'rab of are asma that are called asma mudhar. And six come out of that. Isi mufrad, muthanna, jam'u mudhakkar salim, jam'u mu'annath salim, jam'u taksir, and last but not least, asma'ul khamsa, ama asma'ul sita. Those six come out of the isim mudhar. And the two that come out of the af'al, which is fi'lul mudhari' alladhi lam yattasil bi'akhirhi shay, and amthilatul khamsa. Those are the eight which I'rab is done on. Khalas. You never do I'rab of anything other than those eight. But the six here that we're talking about, brothers here, pay attention. That we're talking about, they only come back from one, which is ism mudhar. Asma which are mubhama. What does asma mubhama mean? Mubham means an ism, it's a noun that is ambiguous. It's not owned by any particular person. The opposite of ibham is ta'yin. What's the opposite of ibham? Ta'yin. If I narrow it down to a particular person, it means now it's known, it's you. Are you with me? Mubham means, are you there, brothers? And three things are mubham. Two are the mains, the third one is differed upon. Ismu ishara is mubham. And asma which are mawsoola, alladhi, allati, alladhani, allati, alladhina, sah? They are what? Mubham. And hadha and hadhihi and ha'ulai, all of them are what? They're mubham. Because who owns hadha? Who owns it? Is it owned by any particular person? Do you know a guy called hadha? So if I say hadha, your question is like, which one? Everything there in front of you is hadha. It's mubham. It's ambiguous. It's not clear yet. You have to say hadha ar-rajul, that man. If it's six men walking, you're still not clear in what you're saying. Then you say that tall man. Okay, now you've become, because all the rest were all short. Does that make sense? Asma which are mubham are general. How is it general? It's not owned by a particular person. It has to be general, right? That's how the generalization came. And the author gave example of man and ma. Man is used for aqil, and ma is used for ghayru aqil. And other than that, they both mean the same. The only difference between the two, according to the author here, is that one is for aqil and one is for ghayru aqil. Aqil means something that has an aqal, and ma is used for something that doesn't have no aqal. The fourth wording that shows generalization is النكرة في سياق النفي. A negation in the context of a in the context of a, sorry, an indefinite in the context of a negation. An indefinite, the word is indefinite, it's nakira, it's not mu'arraf, it's nakira, it's indefinite. It doesn't have alif and lam in there. Are you with me? And the sense, this context that it's in, it's a negation, you're negating something. This also shows generalization. And a lot of the times when you find in that context that there's the la and nafiyah in front of it, and then the nakira comes. That's what the author says. And that's why he says, wala fi nakirat. But it's not the only one. Then the author summarized in this particular chapter two mas'ala. He concluded the chapter after having spoken about all that which we mentioned. He done khatm of this chapter with two points. The first one is, وَالْعُمُومُ مِنْ صِفَاتِ النُّطْقِ. He mentions that the generalization are from the characteristics of utterance. What he's trying to say that to you is that generalization occurs from utterance. مِنْ صِفَاتِ الْأَقْوَالِ الْوَارِدَةِ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. So the thing that you can say is general has to be a speech. The second thing he concludes with, which is what? He says, وَلَا يَجُوزُ دَعْوَ الْعُمُومِ فِي غَيْرِهِ مِنَ الْفِعْلِ وَمَا يَجْرِي مَجْرَاهُ. That it is not permissible, he says, for you to claim generalization in anything other than a speech. You're not allowed to. Are you with me? Such as actions. Just because the Prophet did an action, it doesn't show generalization, he's trying to say. So he's trying to say, it's مُمْتَنِعُ لَا يَجُوزُ. The only thing you can claim that there's a generalization in is if there's a utterance, if there's a speech regarding it. And this is a mas'ala in the books of Usul al-Fiqh, which they deal with very highly, which is the issue known as قَضَايَ الْأَعْيَانِ الَّتِي لَا عُمُومَ لَهَا. They say قَضِيَةُ عَيْنِ لَا عُمُومَ لَهَا. This is a specific situation of the Prophet, it has no generalization, you're not allowed to do it. And for, an example for that is, the Prophet prayed inside the Kaaba. Did he not? Are you allowed to go and pray inside the Kaaba today? سَقَضِيَةُ عَيْنِ لَا عُمُومَ لَهَا. Can you do that for wajib, sorry. The Prophet did it with a nafila. Are you allowed to make it general and say that? I can do it for wajib as well. Huh? This is a mas'ala you can't use. We're going to come to that in more details بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ. Now.
والخاص يقابل العام والتخصيص تمييز بعض الجملة وهو ينقسم إلى متصل ومنفصل. فالمتصل الاستثناء والشرط والتقييد بالشرط والتقييد بالصفة. والاستثناء إخراج ما لولاه لدخل في الكلام. وإنما يصح بشرط أي يبقى من المستثنى منه شيء، ومن شرطه أن يكون متصلا بالكلام. يجوز تقديم الاستثناء على المستثنى منه، ويجوز الاستثناء من الجنس ومن غيره، والشرط يجوز أن يتأخر عن المشروط، ويجوز أن يتقدم على المشروط. والمقيد بالصفة يحمل عليه المطلق، كبقبة قيدت بالإيمان في بعض المواضع، وأطلقت في بعض المواضع، ويحمل المطلق على المقيد، ويجوز على المقيد.
مقيدة.
ويجوز تخصيص الكتاب بالكتاب، وتخصيص الكتاب بالسنة، وتخصيص السنة بالكتاب. تخصيص السنة بالسنة، تخصيص النطق بالقياس، ونعني بالنطق قول الله سبحانه وتعالى وقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The author rahimahullah now goes into another unit, another fasl min fusuli, min fusulha usul al-fiqh. We're now going to go into qas, the opposite of am. We learnt what am means. We took some mabahith and some mashallah good research on the issue of generalization. We're now going to move on to specification. Something is khas, specific. The author rahimahullah, he defined what khas means. He says, wal khasu ma yuqabilu al-amma. Khas is the opposite of am. So in other words, if you learnt what am is, which is general, and you understood what it meant, then it's the opposite. That's all it is. So what did we define as am? We said, huwa al-qawlu al-mawdu'. It is the word which the Arabs have placed, لِاسْتِغْرَاقِ جَمِيعِ أَفْرَادِ بِلَا حَصْرٍ. That's what we said, right? It is the word that the Arabs have placed. And when they placed this word, they placed it so it encompasses many things without any exclusivity. It's not exclusive to anything. Well, the opposite is going to be easy. Is that الْقَوْلُ الْمَوْضُوعُ لِلدَّلَالَةِ عَلَى فَرْدٍ مَعَ حَصْرٍ. It is the word which the Arabs have placed, or the speech which the Arabs have placed, to indicate exclusivity to a particular part of the general, specific to one part.